enemies, because if you kill me, you still not going to get my favor.
Yes.
Favor
yes.
is not transferred because somebody kills you. Favor is not transferred because somebody assassinates your character. Favor is not transferred because somebody lied on you. I don't care what it is people are trying to do to stop you. If you keep moving forward in God, in the course of time, God's going to still get his glory. See, that's what enemies rarely understand. They think that favor is about them and their glory, but favor is never about a person. It's always about God. That's why if you ever get a disobedient and you think that you are so favored, the Bible says that God has a ram in the bush. You are replaceable. God will get his purpose performed whether you act right or not. Oh, you better read scripture. When Saul became disobedient, the very next chapter, God sent Samuel to anoint David.
Yeah.
Don't lose your anointing because you've been disobedient. And may I stop by and tell you that just because you've been functioning in a position for years does not mean that you are anointed.
Yeah.
God is the only employer who will fire you and still let you show up to work.
That's it. That's it.
Saul remained the king for 17 years after God fired him. Because God was proving a point. I'll let you work for free and I'm still going to make somebody else
pay.
This is what I am talking about. When favor gets jealous of favor, everybody on your feet, I'm done. Understand that so often as favorite people of God, we get so distracted by who does not like us. And that really is irrelevant. Because if you stay in God, even the people that don't like you will end up having to bless you. That's why Romans 8 and 28 says, all things work together for the good of the ones who love the Lord. When you finish up Samuel, you understand that it was Saul himself that set David up to be king when he fell on his own sword. See, the reason why you ain't got to fight your enemies is because scripture reveals when you listen, understand this. When you get into New Testament, we see that Judas betrays Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus never addresses Judas again. Jesus never addressed Judas again. But when you keep reading scripture, Matthew 27 and 5, it says that Judas went and hung himself. Understand this. You don't ever have to hang your enemies. If you stay in God, your enemies will hang themselves. I'm talking about when favor gets jealous of favor. Abel never got a chance to get Cain back. But I want you to finish reading that chapter on how God dealt with Cain. You need to make up in your mind, I'm done worrying about my enemies. I'm going to work for the Lord. Because I've lived long enough to know that God can handle my enemies far better than I ever can.
Thank you.